you do after you break through that matters most.
Living your life in anticipation, wondering why it took forever, almost out of ammunition. So grab your fringes by the hand and say, we can make it if we try. Fist in the air. The glass ceiling. Give it a while, it won't take much longer. You're asking me, but know the answers. You're looking around for restoration. Don't worry about what people have to say, 'cause we can make it if we try.
We can make it, you and I,
away from all pain.
We can make it.
Yes, we'll fly.
We can make it.
Yes, we'll fly. So put your fist in the air. The glass ceiling, the glass ceiling.
Heavenly connector. It's the universal language. You may not speak English, but you speak music. We may not speak English, but we speak love. We may not share the same faith, but we share compassion. One team, one dream. Hey! Come on, y'all. One team, one dream. One team, one dream. Hey! One team, one dream. Come on now. I want you at home right now. Wherever you're watching this, I want you to go deep inside. Because you see, this thing called life, it's an inside job. It's an inside job. No more pointing the finger. We're going inside. After me. Break through the glass ceiling. Break through the glass ceiling. Break through the glass ceiling. Break through it. Again, y'all. Break through the glass ceiling. break through the glass ceiling. Break through the glass ceiling. Break through. We're going up, fellas. Come on now. Let's go. Let's go. Come on. Break through the glass ceiling. 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 Everybody, let's go. Break it. Break it. Break it. Break it. Break it. Break it. Could you imagine if your Lord, my Lord, whomever, the higher power, told you, hey, you get 50,000 breaths. Would you have that conversation that you've been delaying? Would you argue with that person that isn't worth your time? What would you do? What are you doing with your measure of breath? Examine people, places, and things. My mom used to tell me, Jew, don't be afraid to be vulnerable. Volunteer to be vulnerable. It is the biggest and best measure of courage, according to Brené Brown. Vulnerability will reveal your true essence, your core, who you are. Be vulnerable.
Welcome back inside of Intimate Live. And my favorite part, you might have guessed it, is the intimate aspect. And intimate now with Miss Jully Black. Jully, so amazing. I know people say it a lot, but it really is truly so amazing to have you here inside of FEVA TV.
Well, thank you. I mean, FEVA, it's all types of hot up in here. You know what I'm saying?
And that may be because of you, of course, hot like that. That was crazy. Like, that is, you know, it defies reason. And I'm actually really excited to be able to sit down and ask you some questions intimately in respects to what makes Jully Black go and the fact that, I mean, has anybody ever called you a liar? And I'm gonna tell you what, I'm gonna elaborate on that. Because you say that you've been around for 27 years, like that you look like you're 25, so that doesn't arithmetic doesn't work, right? It doesn't work. Talk about that realization when you wake up and you say, man, I've been at the top of my craft, not just doing it, but at the top of your craft for such a long time. What do you attribute that to?
Well, it's interesting because I've never said to myself, I'm at the top of my craft. So thank you for like acknowledging that. But what I recognize is that I was given this gift. I was given it for free. At 6 years old, God opened my mouth and a voice came out that was really a voice of healing in church. And so it was about stewardship. It still is. Right now, I'm finally at in a space in my life where I realize that that my voice is, it's medicine. It has it has an opportunity to not just heal others. I'm finally using my voice to heal myself. You know, experiencing trauma, childhood trauma, going through lots of things. I realized that, you know, just him is singing a hymn could really start the healing.
Amazing, the power that is in our breath and what we speak. And, you know, so powerful when you think, let's take it back. 1997, you're young and, you know, doing your thing, and you have a big song playing all over the country. It's taking you back to the days of the Circle. Yeah, I said the Circle. Chocolier, and you had What It Takes, your first Juno win. Talk about that, 1997. What was that like at that time, just from a music standpoint?
If I think back to then, it just went over my head. It wasn't... I wasn't present. There wasn't anybody that looked like me from Canada doing that. So hip-hop became the husband of R&B, which is my voice.
Yes.
And so I remember being grateful when we shot the video. And, you know, Director X at the time, you know, doing all that. We were just kids. It really, having fun. And I think that there's so much commerce and so much money involved now as the fuel that I really hope that this next generation could focus on the purpose really, and then the rest will come. The prosperity will follow.
Right. The passion that you guys exhibited and how much fun it was to kind of be a DJ and to be involved at that time where we saw the talent. And at times, we didn't even know what we were seeing. It just, it felt right. Mm-hmm. It resonated. And when we look now, because we said 1997, 2021, if you had advice for 1997 Jully, what would you tell her?
What would I tell 1997
Jully? What would you tell her?
I would tell her you are enough. I would tell her don't be hang with anyone that's gonna not celebrate you. You know, people shouldn't. You know, you're gonna experience people that are full of tolerance, but you really need people to celebrate. I would say that. That trust God, it does work out, and enjoy your youth. Don't be in a hurry to be an adult.